like it, you did it. You did it. You did it. You said that you would do it, and indeed you did. I thought that you would ruin it. I doubted you'd do it. But now I must admit it and succeed. You did. You should get a medal or be even made of life.
Perfect, Mr. Stafford. Really nothing.
All alone you hurdled every obstacle in sight.
Now wait. Now wait. Give credit where it's due. A lot of the glory goes to you.
But you're the one who did it, who did it, who did it. The study of Gibraltar not a second that you thought of that to rap about it. You did it. I must have aged a year tonight, at times I thought my night right. Never was there the moment any longer.
Shortly after we came in, I saw at once we easily win, and after that I found it deadly.
You should have heard of the rules and laws, every month of which you are.
You think they've never seen a lady before?
And when the Prince of Transylvania asked to meet her, and gave his arm to lead her to the floor, I said to him, you did it, you did it, you did it. They thought she was ecstatic and so devilish, and they never knew that you.
Thank heavens for Sultan Jafar, if it weren't for him, I would have died of boredom. He was there all right, and up to his own tricks.
How far from that dreadful Hungarian, he was there.
Yes. That blackguard uses a science of speech, or to blackmail and swindle and teach. He made it a devilish business of his to find out who this his dual little is. Every time we looked around, there he was, that hairy hound from Budapest. Never leaving us alone, never have I ever known a ruder pest. Finally, I decided it was foolish not to let him have his chance with her. So I stepped aside and let him dance her. Losing charm from every door, he oiled his way. Every trick that he could play, he used to strip a mask away. When at last the dance was done, he glowed as if he knew he'd won. And with a voice too eager and a smile too broad, he announced to the hostess that she was a fraud.
No.
Jawohl. Instructed in their native language, English people aren't. And although she may have studied with an expert dialectician and grammarian,
I can tell that she was born Hungarian!
Not only Hungarian, but of royal blood. She is a princess!
I know you.
Slippers and
enough for you. I don't matter, I suppose.
You are my pet, you presumptuous insect. I want it. Why did you throw those slippers at me?
Because I wanted to smash your face. I'd like to kill you, you selfish brute. Why didn't you leave me where you picked me up out of, in the gutter? Oh, you think all is all over. Now you can throw me back again there, do you?
So the creature is now.
No!
Throw it in, you cat! How dare you show your temper to me? Sit down and be quiet! You shouldn't have said that, Eliza. That shows a want of feeling.
I'm sorry. I'm only a common, ignorant girl, and in my station I have to be careful. There can't be any feeling between the like of you and the like of me. Will you tell me, please, what belongs to me and what doesn't?
You may take the whole damned household, if you like. Except the jewels. They're hired. Will that satisfy you?
Stop, please. Will you take these to your room and keep them safe? I don't want to run the risk of their being missing.
No, Pamela.
Tell me.
For a second there, I thought you were somebody else.
Who?
Forgive me, Mom. Early morning life adventures are
nice. Can I get you a taxi, Mom? A lady like you shouldn't be walking around London alone at this hour of the morning.
No, thank you.
Morning, miss.
Yeah. Anything you can do to assist in her recovery will be frightfully appreciated. Would you be slighted if I didn't speak for hours?
Of course not.
Would you be livid if I had a drink or two?
Nonsense.
Would you be wounded if I never sent you flowers?
Never.
Then my kind of woman be like you. A man in a million may shut bits. Now and then there's one with slight defects. One perhaps whose truthfulness you doubt a bit, but by and large we are a marvelous sex. My kind of woman behave like a man. Then it's a friendly, would mention a time, a better companion you never will find. If I were hours late for dinner, would you mellow?
Of course not.
If I forgot your silly birthday, would you fuss?
Nonsense.
Would you complain if I took out another fellow?
Indeed, Henry. No woman could resist such an invitation.
I can time to put on my best Sunday manners for this thing I created out of the squashed cabbage leaves and covered garden.
Yes, dear, that is precisely what I mean.
I'll see her damned first.
How did you ever learn manners with my son?
It was very difficult. I should never have known how ladies and gentlemen behave if it hadn't been for Colonel Pickering. He always showed me that he felt and thought of me as if I was something better than a common flower girl. You see, Mrs. Higgins, apart from the things one can pick up, the difference between a lady and a flower girl is not how she behaves, but how she is treated. I shall always be a flower girl to Professor Higgins because he always treats me as a flower girl and always will. But I know I shall always be a lady to Colonel Pickering because he always treats me as a lady and always will.
Henry, please don't grind your teeth.
The vicar is here now. Shall I show him into the garden?
The vicar and the professor. Good heavens, no. I'll see him in the library. Eliza. If my son should begin to break things, I give you full permission to have him evicted. And Henry, dear, if I were you, I should stick to two subjects, the weather and your health.
Wanting me in that way? Why, not for the dresses and the taxes. I did it because we were pleasant together. And I came to care for you, and not to want you to make love to me, and not forgetting the difference between us, but more friendly like.
Yes, of course, that's exactly how I feel. And how Pickering feels. Eliza, you're a fool.
That is not a proper answer to give me.
Well, that's the only answer you get from me until you stop acting like a plain idiot. If you're going to be a lady, you're going to have to stop feeling neglected if the men in your life don't spend half their time snivelling over you and the other half giving you a black eye. You find me cold, selfish, and unfeeling, don't you? Very well. They offer you to the sort of people you like. Marry some sentimental whore or another with lots of money and a thick pair of lips to kiss you with and a thick pair of boots to kick you with. If you can't appreciate what you've got, you'd better get what you can appreciate.
Oh, I can't talk to you. Oh, you turn everything against me. I am always in the wrong. But don't you be too sure that you have me under your feet to be trampled on and talked down. I'll marry Freddie. I will. As soon as I'm able to support him.
Freddie? That poor devil couldn't get a job as an errand boy, even if he had the guts to try for it. Woman, do you not understand? I had made you a consort for a king.
Freddie loves me. That's king enough for me. I don't want him to work. He wasn't brought up to it as I was. I'll go and be a teacher.
Oh, what will you teach in heaven's name?
What you taught me, I'll teach phonetics.
Oh, oh, oh.
I'll offer myself as an assistant to that brilliant town girl.
What? That ignoramus? A Tony A. Humbug? You teach my methods, my discoveries. You take one step in that direction, and I'll bring your neck. You hear?
Leave away! What do I care? That's a ringing, ringing incident. Now I don't care that for your bullying and your big talk. What a fool I was! What a dominated fool to think you were the earth and sky! What a fool I was!
goodbye, Professor Higgins. I shall not be seeing you again.
Thank you. to you.